Hi everyone, this is Billy. I'm designing a passive vertical hydroponic system because I see that most of the vertical hydroponic system like tower garden or garden tower or vertical garden, whatever, they are run using the aeroponic or NFT that require pumps and require the flow of nutrient and recycling of the nutrient. So this is a little bit less efficient, and also for the plants, the passive hydroponic system like cracky or the autopod that has water level control will allow the plant to naturally absorb the amount of nutrient they need. Nutrient is not circulated, so avoid deposit of salt along the path of the water and along the symptom of drinking from someone's pee or toilet. Because by recycling, circling, the output of one plant becomes the input of another plant, right? So it's like drinking from someone's toilet. For this passive hydroponic tower that I'm designing, it is using the 160 or 200 mm PVC pipe like this one. So one idea is to design it all in 3D and print it, but I try that is printing too long. Printing this whole thing, even with the lowest resolution, 0.3 mm layered height, require about 24 hours. And I'm just printing with 3 mm thickness, which may not be thick enough to be durable. Yeah, ideally, it should be printed with 4 mm walls. The other idea is to design it first and then somehow try to handcraft it using the PVC pipe. So I'm trying to experiment which one will be better. But just for the design, appreciate your feedback if you see what can be improved. So it basically worked like that. Let me give you the whole tower. So we have a section of PVC pipe, and then a section of this tower garden unit, or vertical, I call it vertical passive hydroponic unit, and then one PVC pipe, one unit, one PVC pipe, one unit, and stack up like that, right? This whole stack is around 1.6 meter high. And for this, each unit, it will be like this. Because it's non-cycling, the bottom of the unit must be watertight, must be water sealed. And there's a pipe at the middle to pass the feeding pipe from a reservoir or pass the electricity wires if we are using grow lamps that are hanging from the top. So I need the middle pipe to be sealed as well. And I made the lower part with the fillet, so when you push this water pipe in, the PVC pipe in, it will be secured. Also at the top. So how do we replenish the nutrient? Okay, one way is using the water level controller that I published earlier. You can have a tank at the top. So maybe the top pipe is a tank actually. So this top PVC pipe, it can be made as a tank. So the nutrient can be held there, and then there's a pipe feeding all the way down. We have T-joint to connect to the water level controller at each unit. Okay. So for example, this one, there should be a water level controller sitting on this unit here at the base and keep the water level around 2 centimeters or 1 inch high. And then the roots of the plants will be able to hang off from the end of the net cup, the net basket that is put in here. The roots will hang from there. There will be a distance between the roots, between the body of the roots and the nutrient surface, right? So some part of the root will be submerged in the nutrient, and I think around 1/3, 2/3 of the root will be hanging in air. So we can aerate the root that way. So the other way to feed nutrient and replenish it, if you don't want to have a tank at the top and run this water level controller, is to just have a drinking bottle. The drinking bottle will be inverted and fitted with a pipe. The pipe will be long enough to reach to the bottom of the tank. So the pipe will be sealed up with the cap of the drinking water bottle. And we put nutrient into the bottle, invert it. At the end of the pipe, that will be the water level. So we'll just need to adjust the length of the pipe that connected with the water basket. The drinking bottle, so that the water level can be maintained. When the water drops below the water level, the water bottle will release a lot of water to fill up to that level. At the same time, bring in some bubble, some air exchange. So you see air bubbles coming up. That will help to aerate the root as well. So this is the two ways I'm thinking about. Again, let me know if you have any feedback. My main concern is two-way. Number one is the flow of air for the root, right? Because all this tower is sealed. So there's no airflow of the roots. This is covered. The bottom is also covered. So there's no airflow. The only airflow is coming from the crack at this net cups or the growth baskets. So there will be some air here. I'm not sure whether that will be enough. Unlike the rain tower or tower garden, the running nutrient will somehow bring air into the pipe. So the pipe will get fresh air. But in my design, there seems to be no way to get a lot of fresh air. There may be some fresh air coming in through the growth basket, but may not be a lot. The other concern is the safety. Yeah, well, this tower needs to be secured firmly and is tall, more than 1.5 meters, so it may fall. So I need a very wide base. Maybe the base will be used to hold the reservoir of nutrient as well. So when someone needs to replenish the water bottle, then they can just replenish it from the reservoir at the bottom. Or there's a way to have a semi-automated system. The reservoir at the bottom will have a pump, but the pump is not pumping every day, every 30 minutes, like that of the tower garden. The pump will be pumping once or twice a day just to replenish the tank at the top. So the tank at the top will not be that heavy. So if the tank at the top is too heavy, it may tip over, right? So we want to keep as less water, less nutrient at the top as possible. So most of the nutrient will be at the bottom, and we will keep pumping once or twice a day, and then there will be a water level controller electronically shut down the pump. So when the water reaches certain level, it will shut down the pump, and then the pump will go on maybe once a day just to replenish this tank. Okay, that's all I have. I'm still trying to print out that big one. I've just finished printing and I'll show you at the end of the video how it looks like. Because my printer is not big enough, I can only print up to 200 times 200 times 200 millimeter. But this unit has the 160 millimeter PVC pipe plus whatever extruding from there for the 32mm growth basket, that already exceeded 200 millimeter. So I have to chop off all these small pipes and then I'll need to print it separately.